Concerned with these low power LEDs. A higher power LED you might want to use a driver for. But if money is no object, you could use a driver for these, but normally it would be better just to use a resistor. It's a very simple circuit. So how do you select the resistance value? Well, you need to know a couple parameters of your LED. One parameter is its current rating. If you look at the data sheet, there'll be a maximum continuous current. You normally don't want to exceed that because you can decrease the life of the LED. And if you grossly exceed the current, you can actually burn the LED out. The other parameter is the forward voltage. But with a single dye LED, with the indium gallium nitride type, which are the blue, white, and bright greens. Typically, the forward voltage is around 3 volts. It does depend on current, but at normal operating currents, the forward voltage would be around 3 volts. Now, if you have the lime green, yellow, amber, orange, or red types, those have a typical forward voltage of around 2 volts, give or take. Okay, here's our sample circuit. We have our supply voltage, the resistor we're going to figure the value of, the LED itself, and ground. You can think of this as a ladder of voltage drops. Now, starting at ground or zero, you climb up higher, voltage drop of the LED, then the voltage drop of the resistor plus the LED, which brings us up to the supply voltage. Another important thing to understand is that the current is going to be the same in each part of the circuit. The current flowing through the resistor is going to be the same as the current flowing through the wire and the LED. So how do you figure the value of this resistor? Well, it's quite simple. You just take the supply voltage minus the forward voltage drop of your LED and divide it by the current that's going through the circuit. So to make an example, let's say we have a supply voltage of 5 volts. We're using a blue LED which has a forward voltage drop of 3 volts. And we want to put 20 milliamps through the LED. Well, we put in the formula here and we get 100 ohms. So what I did, I set up a circuit in this bright eye-blinding blue LED. That's a 100-ohm resistor, and I measured it